And we've definitely had some surprises along the way. These are all these young ladies are under 17.
You know, the funny thing about cadets is you get, because they're at the age they are, you'll get kids who are grown really tall, and some who are grown have not yet hit their growth spurt.
First up in our lineup is Emily Vermeule of the USA, Lim Tae-hee of Korea, from Kazakhstan, Tamila Muridova. And from Hong Kong, Kaylin Sin Yan Che. And our referees for tonight. Kenichi Sasada of Japan, Fikrat Valiev of Azerbaijan, Simona Pierucci of Italy, and Aida Casanova of Uzbekistan.
Nice diversity in the mix of the competitors here, but you know, I'm surprised there are no Europeans in there, but I think that's a little more common with the cadets.
It is more common with the cadets, but this mix is a really, really interesting one. We won't be seeing that in the men's, but we've got some big matchups here. And as we get ready for our first semifinal, that is Emily Vermeule of the USA and Lim Tae-hee from Korea. Vermeule, in the quarterfinals, knocked out number one seed Asel Vasiak of Belgium. And in the quarterfinals, 16, she took out Kowalczyk of Italy. And in the 32, Jaramillo of Colombia. And her opponent, Lim Tae-hee, knocked out Kinga Dekani of Hungary, Claire Bedingfield of the USA, and Kim So-hui, her teammate from Korea. And, you know, both of these fences have looked really, really strong all day and look very mature. You know, if you reach this point, you know, you were talking about that growth spurt thing, but there's a mental growth spurt that, you know, is happening about this time, isn't it?
Yes. And, you know, the Koreans have a very disciplined training program. I mean, these kids and then the seniors, they work very hard. It's not that others don't, but the Koreans especially have put a tremendous effort into developing their fencing program over the last several years at all levels. And we're seeing Koreans in the finals more today than we ever have in the history of fencing.
Tell us something about, you know, you were talking last night quite a bit about pistol grip versus French grip and pommeling. Mm-hmm. We've got two French grips out here.
We have two French grips. We have two right-handed fencers. They'll be fencing more in the center of the strip, more or less. And, you know, the French grip is, of course, the long, skinny handle that's the typical traditional grip on a foil or an épée. The only difference is in épée fencing, what the fencers have started doing is what we call posting, where you hold the grip with where the end of it is sort of in the palm of your hand, and it gives you an extra inch or two of length. And so if you're a shorter fencer.
Hold on, I'm going to interrupt you here because we've had our first call of non-combativity in our first period in the semifinals. Now, what that means is that we roll directly into the second period. After around a minute, a referee, if he sees nothing indicating that they're going to fight, We'll roll straight on through without a break. And that's our first call of that. And we are more likely to see that in Epe than anywhere else.
Yes. Well, it gives the fencers incentive to fight if they haven't been fighting to the level that the referee would like to see, or if they're hesitant to fight. It does encourage them because it shortens the time. So they're posting. What they're doing is they're holding the grip so that they have a little more distance. It does give you a little less leverage, and it makes it a little bit easier to beat the blade. But these girls are evenly matched because they're both posting. So they're both going for a little extra distance with the blade. A nice pick to the hand there by the American girl on the Korean on Lim. When you're fencing in French grip like this, point control is more difficult. So that type of a touch is really very impressive. The other thing is you see the Korean girl Lim going for the toe, and when you have that extra distance, going for the toe is a little bit of a better bet because you've got a little more distance and you're safer.
Now, it has been all Vermeule so far, and this is, she's very calm, very controlled, and this is exactly what she was doing in her quarterfinal match against the number one seed, and it was very frustrating for her opponent because this Emily Vermeule doesn't get rattled very easily.
One thing that's interesting, back to this pistol grip thing and back to the French grip, is that years and years ago, I was looking at pictures from the Olympic Games today and from the past, and they used to have this same kind of grip, but they didn't hold it at the end. They held it up right up against the bell, just like you do with a pistol grip. And it used to be for a little while that you could sort of throw the blade as you were attacking, and it would give you extra distance to fool your opponent, and that became illegal. So you can hold it up close or you can hold it far out, but you have to do one or the other point by point. You can't change where you're holding it during the action.
During an action, yeah. Well, nice. Faint into the low line from Lim, and very deftly executed. Looked like she was going to go nice. For the foot, and then up. And
that was a beautiful combination move. And a lot of times in Epe, you've got time to think about things, so you spend your first minute or so doing sort of reconnaissance on the other fencer, trying to see how they respond to different moves.
Vermeule off the side of the piste. And
it's a narrow edge.
Our referee, Sasada, over to make sure she's okay. Fortunately, it's not a high piste, as we have seen in other events, the piece being really high off the ground, and you can take a real knock when you land.
Yeah.
Neil's stepping into that one and regretting it.
Well, sometimes when you fall like that, it kind of rattles you for a point or two. To sort of get back in the groove.
Oh, lovely there. Right, Lim going into the low line and Vermeule in over the top.
Right, and that's when someone comes in for your toe, the classic move defensively is to pull your front foot back and arch over with your weapon hand and pick them off.
Well, we go to our first 1 minute break and fairly evenly balanced here, but I feel like Vermeule still has just a slight edge. What do you think?
I think so. Right now, I think the Korean girl is in a position where she's having to push a little bit, and that might not be the most comfortable thing she wants to do. She's a strong fencer, and she is kind of used to getting ahead quickly. And if she's not ahead, she has to shift her plan and start pushing when she doesn't necessarily want to have to do that. So her coach is probably giving her some advice as to how to be a little more aggressive in a way that will be effective, and perhaps not to go for so many toe touches because those haven't been working for her.
Well,
but we'll see.
One feint to the foot worked well for her, but the toe touches have not. This is our only 1 minute break in this semifinal. Our first period curtailed by non-combativity. We roll into the third and final period in this semifinal match.
And so for those of you who don't know fencing that well, an elimination round goes to 15 points if you fence, if you can do it before the end of the time periods. Typically there's three time periods of 3 minutes, but because of the non-combativity thing we discussed, we jumped one of the periods, so we've got two periods. So effectively they have 6 minutes to fence out the 15 points. But if they don't get to 15, that's okay. Whoever's ahead at the end of the period here of this 2.5 minutes left will win. If they're tied, then they'll go to a 1 minute overtime. Epee fencing is a little easier to understand if you've never watched fencing because there really are fewer rules. You both hit at the same time, you both get a point.
Well, Vermeule reacting slowly as Lim was building that attack, and Lim has come out with a plan.
Well, now she's made up that difference, and well, so now we're at 6-6, and
she's more on her front foot, and now we've got Vermeule basically reacting.
Right.
As opposed to initiating, she is responding,
and
that can be difficult. All right, good counter there from the American.
Well, Vermeule's spent the first 5-6 points on her side of the strip, and right now she's evening it out and pushing a little bit more. Although the Korean does seem to be gaining a little advantage.
Oh, lovely.
Distance.
Vermeule picking up the blade on that attack and able to turn and to get the hit.
The Korean wants to move. Kim wants, the limb wants to move in. She wants to step in. She wants to take small steps to move forward. But now we're starting to see for the first time the action in her side of the strip. So. And once again, point for the American, 9-6, and it's she's opening up a little bit of a lead, which is, of course, what she wants to do.
Well, she seems to have got control back of this match, and it has all come on defense, this turnaround that she's had. And it switches things around.
That was a bit of a simultaneous attack, which worked for Vermeule, but not for Lim. She got closed out.
Well,
that was
the good
nice
news for Lim is that she made the hit to the foot work, but Vermeule was quick enough to fashion a double out of that.
Well, you really have to step in with those toe touches.
Well, nice distance management there from Lim.
40 seconds left in this match. And now at 12-8, so Lim is really in a situation where she has to make up a four-point deficit in 30 seconds. meaning about 1 point every 10 seconds, which is a lot for an epic.
You know, we talked about this before, that when you are, especially in epee, when you're in this situation and you have to press, it very rarely works to your advantage.
Right, very often you become sloppy. It's very hard to even practice those kinds of situations. The action was stopped as they crossed.
As they did, and to Vermeule's benefit, about 6 seconds ran off the clock in the process.
Right. 12 seconds left in the match.
Yeah.
10 seconds.
All Vermeule has to do is step back, pick up the attack.
Right. This is a tough spot to be in for Lim.
And that'll do it. It is Vermeule into the gold medal match, 15-9 over Lim Tae-hee of Korea. Lim will take home the bronze medal, but despite a few shaky moments, an impressive